Hello and welcome to another HPRC instructional video. In this video I will go over how to use tamubatch. Tamubatch is a tool that runs scripts or commands on the compute nodes without the need to create a job file. Tamubatch generates job files for you. All it takes is a text file of executable commands. Here is an example of what a text file would look like. In this text file, all it is doing is running a Python script called helloworld.py. If I wanted to submit a batch job with these executable lines to Terra, just type tamubatch and then the text file. And it will automatically submit my job to the cluster. When your job is completed, there are two new files in the same directory you submitted your job from. The first file is the job name followed by the job ID, which is your standard output file. In my case, this will contain the output of my Python program. The other file is the text file followed by the error and then the job ID, which contains your standard error. Now, if we take a look at the original text file, you can see that there are batch parameters inserted by tamubatch into the text file. Tamubatch uses flags to allow the user control over batch parameters within a job submission. For information on flags, you can type tamubatch dash help into the command line, and a description of all tamubatch flags will appear. Let's say I wanted to run the same job again with different batch parameters. This time I wanted to run it with 5 hours of wall time, 5 cores, 5 cores per node, and a memory limit of 10 gigabytes. If we take a look at the text file, you can see that the batch parameters correlate with the flags that were used. Tamubatch works in the same way on Ada. The only difference is that lsf commands will be used instead of slurm commands. The extra flag is called when you want to add extra lsf or slurm commands to your batch job that are not already in the provided flags. For example, if you wanted to be alerted by email when your batch job starts and finishes, you can call the extra flag followed by the commands to get the email alerts. Now, taking a look at the text file, can see that the extra flag will bring extra job specifications. And the same aspect on Ada. You can see that it has the same functionality. The command flag adds executable commands to the script file if a script file is provided. This is useful for pre-processing. If no script file is provided, a script file with only the command will be created by tamubatch. If we run the job with the command flag, you can see that tamubatch has inserted a command to be executed in the job submission. This concludes the tamubatch instructional video. For any questions, please email us at help@hprc.tamu.edu. Thanks for watching.